Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stacia Expert Mode. And in this episode, we craft ourselves the premium armor and enchant the heck out of it. And we also get ourselves creative flight. This has been a long time coming, so I hope you enjoy. Okay, so today we are going to be pretty much becoming OP. If possible, I want to make myself an angel ring and one of these sets of armor. I'm not entirely sure which one I want. I've given the mech armor a bit of a go and I don't like it. It doesn't give it much like stats or whatever. Like, I know it kind of protects me pretty well, but I'm sacrificing a lot more than I would with just regular armor. Because like with this armor, of course, yeah, I can jump really high if I hold control, but that's only when I hold control, so it's kind of useless. What's that noise? What's making that? Oh my god, is it this thing? Oh my god, it's the resistive heater. I was like, what the hell's making that noise? Okay, yeah. So, I may have done a few things. Yeah, I may have started rats. Now, the reason why I didn't record and show it is because, well, rats is just a pretty simple thing. You can't go to the Ratlantis dimension, so all I wanted the rats for is for the acceleration upgrade. And wow, my game is getting very laggy. But I have a sack in here of 23 rats, and I have a hole over here where I've been taming them. You see, like, there's a bunch of them in there. But pretty much what I've done with them all is I've tamed them and just turned them into acceleration rats, and I've put them all over the place in here. So they're on every machine here. As you can see, we're actually really struggling on making brine at the moment, which is actually a weird thing because I did set up even more evaporation towers over at the reactor area. So like if we go to reactor, like I have a lot of these guys here, and all of these guys are making brine, which are all being pumped into this ender tank, which are only being used to go into this ender tank. And I have one of them here just keeping us filled with lithium. And then all of these solar neutron activators just pumping it in. So we do have plenty of brine to run the thing, but all the excess brine isn't really like going anywhere. So I need to figure out another way of making more brine. Now, another thing. I may have made myself another dimension. And this dimension is amazing. Probably the best dimension I could have made. It's still active at the moment, and it's called Steel Dim because I tried making this dimension 3 times and it didn't work. Like, if you look in here, Steel Casing Dim, Steel Casing Dim 2, Steel Dim. It just wouldn't place the steel. But if I go in here now, yes, there's a few mobs around, but that's fine. But I have made a whole dimension made of steel casing. This is so good. On so many levels, now I don't have to go through the whole astral sorcery and black iron infusing crafting. This is just amazing. Get rid of these guys here. So I've actually quarried out a good bit of it. I actually got an egg from him. Cool. I've quarried out a good bit of it over here. So I have got, yeah, like quite a lot of steel casing. Like if I look up steel, I have like 68.9k of it. I could have made more, but apparently I went AFK next to the builder and the creeper blew up the builder. I got back the builder, but it's just, it wasn't done mining at all. So yeah, that is pretty much what I've done here. So I've got unlimited steel casing and yeah, it's amazing. And because I have all these rats now, everything is so much faster at crafting. I have rats in here. I don't even know if the rats are actually affecting the export rate on these exporters. But yeah, I don't know. So I'm also breeding rats up in my bedroom here. I got one which I'm keeping as a pet, nice white one. There's another one here like brown and white, but yeah, so I have these guys just constantly producing tamed ones automatically. And the ones in here, like if I have a look in here, the ones that are running these infusing factories are actually underneath it here. So I actually don't know how many of them are there, but if I add any more rats, this thing will fill up so fast that the exporter can't export out fast enough. But I have this thing here making me so much like iron that it's actually out of power. which makes no sense because the cable is full, so this should be inputting in as much power as it can. Are you still filling with crystals? Yeah, you're still getting crystals. Maybe I should take off a rat there. Maybe I have too many on that there. I'll come back to it later. Maybe I'll find a better cable. But anyway, so we need to start setting up a bit of autocrafting. I want to set up autocrafting for either one of my armors, and I want to set up autocrafting for the Angel Ring, because it's going to be quite a big craft. So, let's actually start this thing. So let's start off with ourselves. Oh yeah, I made those. So Angel Ring. Let's start off with the actual Angel Ring. There we go. Should be everything normal. And if I had a look in here, you see, I have everything bar... I have the enriched gold and advanced coils. I need to make myself the gold thrusters now. So gold thruster is made like this. Hopefully that's everything right. Okay. Now I need to make myself a blazing energy cell. Oops. So blazing energy cell is made like this. Now I need to make myself a hardened cell. And then make myself a basic cell. So I should have auto-crafting for all of these parts, which is grand. Now I need to make myself an iron thruster, which is made like this. I think I have everything auto-crafting for that. And I've already got the hardened energy cell, so that's fine. Ender gate blazing. I need to make that now, so that requires these. Now I need to autocraft blazing cable, which is made like this. And let's put all these items in here now. And so next things first is we need to make ourselves a diamond jetpack. So a diamond jetpack, I need to make this recipe. I don't think I actually have diamond chest plate set up, so I'll autocraft that too. Chest plate, diamond jetpack. So jetpack, diamond thrusters are made like this. And now to make myself a niotic battery pack or whatever cell. And I think that's actually nearly it for it. I can make a gold jetpack. I have everything else. Diamond thrusters. Yeah, I might have everything all ready to go. So let's look up ring. Can I make one? Missing 4 elite coils. Missing 5 gold sheet metal. Missing 1 gold jetpack. Okay, I never actually set up a recipe for a gold jetpack. So let's do that now as well. So gold jetpack. I have to go through the whole other jetpack processing. Okay, so I've already made the iron thrusters. Iron jetpack. Leather strap. Now I need to make myself gold sheet metal. So gold sheet metal is made like this. Hope it's the right one. Yep. Now I need to make myself... What was it? Oh yeah, the advanced coils. Now these are reinforced alloy inside of a blood altar. So if I look at alloy, how much do I have? 9k of it. So let's do about 2 stacks of it. That should be more than enough. If I can teleport to the right area. There we go. So now we got our coils. Autocrafting should be ready for everything. So let's put these in here. And if we look up ring again, can I craft it? Oops. Ring. Missing 5 available tree. Did I not just set an autocraft for that? I never put the things in here. My mistake. All right. Ring. Start. Probably has to do a bit of pressing and crafting in the other machine that the multi-server presses. But it shouldn't actually take that long. Has to make ourselves all the dielectric casing. It doesn't need to actually do anything. You can see everything's going through really quickly right now. Right, so while that's crafting, let's actually make ourselves a couple of other machines. Let's start using up this essence. So let's make ourselves an enchantment factory. So enchant, and if I go to here, so enchantment factory, let's autocraft one of those. I'm missing 2 netherite scrap. Even though I mined up a bunch of that debris, I never actually processed it. So let me actually quickly do that now. All right, that should be enough scrap for now. Teleport back and make ourselves the enchantment factory. There we go. Enchantment applicator. And I don't think I need anything else, because if I need to remove any enchants, I can just use the disenchanter right here. So let's go. So let's grab ourselves a cable and let's plug it in right here. I should be able to get cable through the other side of the wall right here. Right here. There we go. So cable through. And we'll just block that back up. So enchantment factory, enchantment applicator. Hopefully with this thing I can add the higher enchants, because I know you can do with a botania, but I'm not anywhere near making enough mana to make myself a botanic enchanter. So I'm hoping this works. Okay, so let's grab ourselves a pipe and let's run this pipe across the top and put ourselves a speed upgrade in there too, so it always has enough fluid. There we go. And now let's make ourselves... Oh, wait, is the ring done yet? It should be. Angel ring. Oh my god, yes. Now I can get rid of this elytra. Even though the elytra is kind of cool, I can put on an angel ring. Now, this can go in a ring, two ring slots or the actual angel slot. So where's the angel slot? Oh, here it is. Angel ring. Oh my god, we have creative flight. This is so good to have. Oh my god, the amount of times I could have used this. This is so good. Right, so in terms of armor now, I don't want the mech suit. So let's dump that and this. There we go. So now, the armor we need to decide on. So the benefits of infused armor is that it's got way higher base defense. The benefits of the premium armor is that it can have all these extra augments. So like I can have a health boost on my chest plate. I can have strength on a sword. I can have like speed on my leggings and run super fast. And I can have jump boost. Like I can jump really high if I have it on my boots. So that's one good thing about the premium armor. And I can enchant it like crazily as well. So like, I mean, there's 6 damage in the difference. So it's hard to know. I can make the premium right now, but I would have to set up a few more things with semi-stable ingots and all that. Even though it's easy to make, I don't know if this stuff doesn't explode. It's not like back in regular extra utils. This is mini utils, so it's like a port of it. Part of me really wants to go with the premium. One, it looks cooler. And well, look, technically, I'm not going to be wearing it because I'm going to be keeping this pink armor on as a cosmetic. So you know what? We'll probably just go with the Supremium. I think that's probably our best bet because we can have all these augments, which this armor doesn't. And we get, yeah, okay, we'll go with the premium. So we need to set up all the crafts for all of this stuff. Technically, I don't need to. I can just make it simply. Let's say you at mystical agriculture. And let's just make ourselves like a stack of each ingot. There we go. Now I need to make myself a stack of each gem. There we go. Now we got a stack of every gem. All I need to do now is make myself some diamond gear. Actually, I just have to grab out one set because it doesn't matter what durability it is. It just uses it. So just grab out like any pieces of diamond armor. And now if we look up at mystical again, we just go ahead and make our armor. So let's see. Mystical armor. Where is it? There it is. So Inferium helmet. Made like this. And then the chest plate. And the pants. And then, oh, so the durability does transfer over. That's not too bad because we'll add mending onto everything now as well, because we will be taking all the enchants off of this emerald armor. Let's go do that now, actually. Right, there's all the enchants I have right now. So I'll have to go through them all and make sure I have the right ones. Okay, so let's finish making this armor. So we have this now. So we upgrade this one to Prudentium. So Prudentium pants, Prudentium chestplate, Prudentium helmet. Then upgrade this to Teriatum. So upgrade this one now. So the helmet, the pants, the chestplate, and the boots. Now we upgrade it to, what's this one? Imperium. So Imperium boots, Imperium pants, Imperium chestplate, and Imperium helmet. Last but not least, Supremium. So Supremium helmet, Supremium chestplate, Supremium pants, and a Supremium boot. Now with this armor, it's way more durability than everything else. So this is perfect. So let's actually start by actually enchanting a few of these things just in the factory and see what we get. So we got blast protection, rebounding, nature's mend, and mana regen. That's not great. I'd rather have like a really high protection. Protection, mending. Okay, it's got mending and occult evasion. Not sure what that is. I think that's like dodge, like magic attack. Mana boost, soulbound, occult. Okay, unbreaking. What do we get in our boots? Soul speed. Actually, that's not too bad. Magic protection 3, occult aversion 1. Not too happy with any of these. So let's actually take all these enchants off and reapply new ones and see what we get. The other thing I need to make myself now is the actual tools, because I want to upgrade my tools here as well. I'm still deciding whether or not to make a Paxel or just stick with like regular set of tools. I'm still deciding that. Still no good enchants. Let's try the enchantment table. Like, what are we getting here? Gourmand, Insight. Gourmand's good. Bloom, Magnet Tree. I don't actually want any magnets on my thing. Unbreaking, Block Reach. That's one thing I kind of wanted and the other armor did not provide. Fire Protection and then Projectile Protection. Right, I'm going to have to take all these enchants off. And you know what? I'm just going to go through and add all these enchants on and I'll come right back because we'll probably have extra stuff. And we're going to test and see if we can add extra protection onto these things. So I'll be right back. Okay, I may have went through my 1,000 levels trying to do this. I think I was close to 1,000 levels anyway, but I'm down to 9. Yeah, I got my armor completely enchanted. It has a quite actually a decent amount of chance on it. So I got everything that was on my emerald armor back onto it, but I managed to get protection 5 on everything. Now, I would have went way higher, but I just don't have the XP to do it. And if we're going to go any higher, I'd rather do it with Botania, because with Botania, you can actually keep the enchantment book. It just copies it and then applies it to the armor. So you'll always have the same enchant book. You can just apply it to as many items as you want. So yeah, I'm going to wait until I have a everlasting guilty pool. And if we have a look at the pool, we're not too far from getting it. We can make everything except for the Uwotarium, the Cosmic Anime Dinner. I think that's it. And then the Ultimate Singularity. And the Supremium's Ender Pearl. I need to finish making enough black iron to make the pedestal and the crafting core. But other than that, I'm pretty sure we have everything else, like the environmental thing, that's easy enough. I can just craft that using a ritual. The Aetherius Slaves, we have plenty of them. Starlight Infuser, I can make those easy enough. Fabulous Mana Pools is just Shimmer Rock, no problem. Shifting Stars, easy enough. The hardest part is going to be making this block of Uwotarium. Because the Uwotarium is going to require, of course, nuggets to an ingot and then ingot to a block. But the nuggets require piles, and the piles come from Nether Star Essence, Dragon Egg Essence, and Nitro Crystal Essence, 10 million FE. Inside of an energizer. So if I was just to get one essence of each, so like one nether star, one nitro, and one dragon, and if we just go in here and set these things up, so this plus this and then this will require 10 million. And damn, that's actually going quite quick. I thought this would actually be a lot slower. We could actually autocraft this now if we wanted to. We could set up an easy autocraft. I might actually do that quickly. Hang on. So processing. So a dragon egg essence, nether star essence, and a nitro essence. Let's just set this all down to one. One of each. And if we look up Uwu, we have one pile like that. So if we just go like this, hang on, and then upgrade this to a nugget, then upgrade this to an ingot, then upgrade this to a block, and then put these recipes in here, and then put this recipe in over here. Okay, bear with me now. And let's say we request, go back to block, or just look up Uwu again. How hard is it to make 64? Oh, okay, I'm missing like 31,000 of it. But if I just want to make 10 blocks of it, I can. So if we come back over here now, it should be auto-crafting all the little piles and then auto-craft the piles into nuggets, and then the nuggets into ingots, and then the ingots into blocks. And 10 blocks might be enough. Like, it's used in here. It just requires 2 blocks, and then I need some ingots, or the pearls. Oh, God, yeah, okay, I'm going to need way more than that then. So I guess in between episodes, I guess I'll be working on making as much of this Uwotarium as I can. And the blocks of black iron blocks, I'll have to set up autocrafting for that now soon as well. So I might even look into maybe doing this next episode. Because I also want to get into the mod Woot then too. Because Woot is going to be needed to make ourselves some of the other things. Like in here, if we ultimate crafting, we're going to need it for liquids in here. So like purge fluid, enchant, dye, Conatus, there's a few of them in here. So I need all of these different buckets of fuel to make ourselves the create a fluid tank, which would be great for our brine at the moment because we're running completely out of that if we want to keep our ore processing at max capacity even faster. But anyway, there's still one few things left to do. Let's make ourselves our augments and our tools. So I need to make myself the swords now. So diamond sword, up into this sword, into this sword, and then into this sword. And then last but not least, a Supremium Sword. There we go. So a Strength Augment is going to require 2 Quartz, Supremium, and a Strength Augment 4. One, and I need a few of these things. So attuned. Let's grab ourselves, I don't know, 10 of them. I don't even know if that's how many I need. According to that, I only need 4 of them. So let's start with the Jump Boost. Jump Boost is going to require Rabbit's Foot. Now, Rabbit Foot, I actually haven't seen any rabbits at all. So I know rabbits spawn in the desert. So if we can grab ourselves a Mob Egg. So let's look at Mob Swab and, oh, that's auto-crafting, hang on. Mob Swab, there we go. And if we just now fly to a desert, where would the next desert be? It'd probably spawn down over here. So let's head to that village and see if we can find ourselves a rabbit. Oh my God, I have been flying around for ages. I had to go to a new desert area just to find this rabbit. Like I had to get a nature's compass and fly all the way down here to this bigger desert even have a chance of finding you. Okay, I have him now. Let me just get... Yeah, give me... There we go. Nice. Okay. Now that I have a mob swab of a rabbit, Let's grab ourselves a waystone and get out of here. All right, home. There we go. So now we need to set this rabbit up inside of the op spawner so we can actually get ourselves tons of rabbit foot. If my game would actually respond, that is. Damn, being away from the base causes some weird lag issues. Anyway, so seed. Grab ourselves a seed. And now we need ourselves a bucket of XP. Do I have one of those? No, I do not. So I have to go up and get one now. So spawners, XP, and combine that there. Stop picking up stuff. Now let's go over to our rabbits over here. Did I say rabbits? I meant chickens. I need to go to our chickens that I have down over here. And I don't think I actually showed this. I have a cheese making system right here. That's how we're able to tame so many rats. I was using mechanical users and cauldrons, but I guess since it rained, it filled up the cauldron. So that wasn't great. But actually, I don't need this anymore. Because right now, it's using this curdling station to make blocks of cheese. And it's pretty powerful. Because I have like over 10,000 blocks of cheese. Right, so rabbit spawn egg. Put away the nature's compass. And if we come all the way up here, we should be able to go in and set this up inside this spawner. That is back here. So rabbit spawn egg in, teleport out. That ender inhibitor is actually stopping me from going out in and out with my sword. But now if we can turn this on, rabbits will go like crazy for a bit. Get away from that because that is quite loud. Now, if we look up rabbit, are we getting some feet? Yes, we are. I'm actually after forgetting what I kind of needed these for. What did I need the feet for again? Oh, yes, the jump boost augment. Right, let's go actually start making all these now. So if we look up essence, we're going to need to get ourselves pretty much everything up as far as prudentium. So essence, do I have any prudentium essence? It doesn't look like it. So I'm gonna have to convert some of this imperium or supremium down to imperium. I don't need it supremium. Oh, I do. Okay, so supremium, imperium, let's break some of this down to terium and it's down to prudentium. All right, that should be everything we need now. Let's head over to our infusing altar right here. Oh, it's a eclipse. I was wondering why it was getting so dark. I thought it was raining. Anyway, so let's start off with the jump boost. So I need an augment, some rabbit feet, and some imperium. So 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This right there. Push the button. That adds on. And then upgrade it then from that into terium. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that not correct? How do I upgrade the jump boost? Jump boost 1 with terium. This is jump boost, right? Oh, do I actually have to pick it up and then put it back down? Because it's weird, like registering. That seems like it might be the issue. All right, so pick it up, put it back down, rabbit foot, and go. So this is the tier 4 jumping. That's perfect. So speed, from my experience, I think a speed 2 is enough. So let's start with speed 1. So that's sugar and prudentium. So unattuned augment, swap this back around. So sugar, 4 sugar, that's 3 and 4, and then prudentium, push the button, here we go, pick it up, put it back down. Let's actually, let's test how fast speed 1 is. So if we go back to our mystical agriculture, we need to make ourselves the actual tinkering table. So let's make that quickly, and you know what, let's keep it over here for right now. I don't necessarily have to have it over my house. So let's grab ourselves our pants, put the pants on, speed augment, and let's grab our boots and put the jump augment on too. Did the speed one not go on? Oh, there we go. So how fast do we run? You know what? That's actually not that bad of a speed boost. And we jump, yeah, quite high. Not as high as we were with the mech suit, but like it's still a decent amount. Let's actually upgrade it to the next speed and we'll probably call it there with that because it's probably any higher than that. We're way too fast. So let's see. So speed augment and then 1, 2, 3, and 4 of that. And then with terium. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 of that. There we go. Let's see how fast this is. So the next one we want is health boost. Now health boost is going to require wither skeletons and golden apples. So that should be easy enough. So speed boost 2. How fast is this now? Oh yeah, we're definitely cruising now. I think any higher than this and we will be just going way too fast to be able to do anything. Because even like, I think I'm walking speed is faster than regular sprinting speed. Like that's insane. And we can jump pretty high. So we're pretty good with this. Okay, so let's make ourselves the health boost and then we can make ourselves our strength. You know what? Let me quickly. I'm actually going to make these now because it'd be a little bit of a process and we're kind of running out of time now. So let me quickly make the last two augments. There we go. So I've got my two augments now. So all I have to do is just apply these on the armor. So chest plate will get a health boost. So that will give us like, we currently have quite a lot of hearts and this is going to give us even more hearts. So this sword goes from 24 damage to 44 without even enchanting yet. And I have a sharpness 10 book that I can add. And I think I already have it on my thing. Yeah. So if I went ahead now and took all the enchants off my sword here. Here we go. Come up to this guy, and I'm just going to add myself mending. Apparently, I can't add mending onto this thing. Why not? The level's way too high. Oh, I can't add mending onto the book, onto the sword at all. Oh, okay. So I don't need leech. I need teleportation because I'm using that to get around. Venom, not really. Sweeping edge, yeah. Soulbound, yes. Beheading, I don't necessarily need it. Vorpal, yes. Sharpness 10, yes. That goes up to 50. Range, teleporter, yeah, I need range for that. Capturing, sure. I can't add it on. I think I'm at my max. So the last two things I want is these two. So 75 and... Okay, so that will, I can add my looting on now as well. The only thing I can't add is capturing, which requires 75 levels, which I should be able to get with just my spawners up here. So let me go see quickly. Let me turn off the rabbit death machine. So speed this all the way up because this tank is nearly completely full. Should give me enough levels to be able to enchant my sword. There we go. And now just teleport home. And now we can add... What did I do with the book? Oh God, did I actually get rid of the book? Hashtag capturing. I have two capturing tree books. Okay, hang on. So capturing, go on like this. Actually, wait, no, I should add these on separately. Give me out this diamond sword. Oh my God, whenever I search up enchanted items, it kind of just lags my entire system, which is so annoying. But just say diamond sword with capturing, and then another diamond sword with another capturing. That equals capturing 4, and then I just take the enchant off and then add it onto my sword. There we go. So capturing, looting, range, sharpens 10, vorpal, soulbound, sweeping edge, teleportation, and strength tree for a total attack damage of 50. Damn. All right. So one last thing we need to do now is make ourselves our pickaxe. So if we go back to our mystical, probably running out of time here now, but I need to decide whether or not to make the actual pickaxe, Paxel, or just go with a regular pickaxe. I think the Paxel would be the best option because it incorporates everything. So I'm going to quickly make myself the Paxel and then we'll enchant it. There we go. Supremium Paxel. Now, pretty much I just want everything off my pickaxe here. So if I just say pickaxe, every enchant to have all enough books, I do. So Paxel, I'm going to give it efficiency. I'm going to give it fortune. I don't need mending. Actually, I do need mending. Doesn't go on there. That's one thing I need to worry about. Is it actually going to give me mending or not? Unbreaking, unless the tool is already unbreakable. Experience boost and soulbound. I don't have enough XP for soulbound. Our soulbound doesn't go on it at all for some reason. I don't even know. Does this thing have durability? Go to the mine and there's a mine. I think this tool is indestructible. The armor is not indestructible, but the tools are. Oh, that's actually so good. Okay, well, we can get rid of our shovel. All these extra enchant books. Yeah, there we go. Damn. So we have like purple hearts now. That's not even the max hearts. Like if I check my heart charm. We only have like 18 hearts in here. We can get way more. And I still need to get way more, but I need to kill the Wither a bunch more times. So I might do that in between episodes then as well. But yeah, damn. So now we have like proper Supremium armor, enchanted like crazy. Oh, it doesn't look that cool as it is in the picture here. But yeah, now we've even got like even stronger swords. Oh, this is great. How's our Ubu-terium actually doing? Just one last thing. Ubu. Haven't crafted any yet, which is a bit odd because it should have made some by now, unless it's keeping it in the system until it's made enough. That could be it. It's stored 4 ingots already. Okay, so it takes a long time before it even makes one block. Okay, that's fair enough. So I'm gonna end it there. Hope you all enjoyed, and if you did, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you're new. Hope to see you all in the next episode. So without further ado, goodbye.